There are a few great all-in-one CRM softwares for small business owners and solopreneurs out there. So what differentiates one from the other? In this video, I'm going to share a few of my favorite micro features in Dubsado. Welcome back to the Productive Co YouTube channel. My name is Ray, and this is the place for all things Dubsado CRM. There are a few other all-in-one client management systems out there, and they all have something unique to offer. Several of these apps have many of the same core features. So how do you know which software is best for you? Well, I think it comes down to what I like to call micro features, those little features that make your experience as a user just extra special and easier. So today I'm going to share 8 Dubsado micro features that you need to know about. This first feature I wanted to share with you is very simple, but it's one of my favorites. It's read receipts. This is a way for you to check up on your clients. If you've ever wondered if a client got your email or your form, you can simply go into their project in Dubsado, click on the respective email you want to view, and you can see here at the bottom of the email that it was sent 2 hours ago and the client last viewed it an hour ago. You can also do the same with forms. You can see here the client viewed the proposal 4 days ago, and they also responded 4 days ago. In this case, you can see that it was sent 2 hours ago, but the client hasn't viewed it yet. Number 2, lead capture redirects. Dubsado has a built-in thank you page. It's completely white, and then in very small text, it says, "Thank you for inquiring," or something of that nature. However, this is an opportunity for you to show off your branding. So instead of having them go to Dubsado's generic thank you page, you can add your own thank you page to be redirected to. So when they hit send, they can be taken to the page of your choice. The third feature I wanted to share is that you can allow gratuity in Dubsado. So if you are in an industry where tipping is either customary or acceptable, you can choose to turn gratuity on. So that way your clients can pay more than the invoice total. You'll go to settings, receive money, and then toward the bottom, there's an option for you to turn gratuity on. You can also have it categorized into a specific bookkeeping category if you want to keep your tips separate from the rest of your payments. And what's great about Dubsado is that if you want to turn it on for a specific client, you can do that. Dubsado also has a feature that allows you to drag and drop your form templates if you've created the wrong form template type. Now, Dubsado allows you to create 5 different form types, and you can see those listed here. Each form type has its own unique features, and if you realize that you've accidentally created the wrong form type and you need to use the features in another form type, you can simply just drag and drop the form to the correct form type. Most people don't know about this next feature, but you can add images to your address book. So if you want to be able to put a face to a name, all you have to do is go into Utilities, Address Book, choose the client name, and you can upload an image that's either their face or maybe their logo. This next feature is a game changer. So this is the ability to add third-party links to projects. So if you go into a project in Dubsado, under the Forms tab, you can upload any of your forms that you have in Dubsado. However, you can also upload one-time links. So if you want to link to some third-party source like a project management tool or Google Drive or Dropbox or an online gallery, you can do that by clicking Create One-Time Link. You'll give the link a title and then put a URL underneath. You want to make sure that you use https://... before you put www. And then you can send it to your client. Dubsado also gives you the ability to create multiple brands if you have multiple businesses. The way you would do that is scroll up to your logo in the upper right corner and click on it. And then down below, you can create a new brand. And then you can see here, these are all of the brands that I have access to. And whenever I want to switch between brands, I'll just go over here and click on the brand I want to view. And
Now for the last feature I wanted to share in this video, and that is called question mapping. So I'm going to show you what it looks like so you have a good understanding. When a client fills out a form, they're going to write their information on that form, and that information is going to live just on that form unless you set up question mapping. So what that does is it allows the information from the form to be transported to another area. So I'm going to open this lead capture here. You can see here I have these questions, and I want to make sure that I don't have to open up this form every time I want to locate the client's phone number. So what I'm going to do is where I've added phone, I'm going to click this open, and then I'm going to select maps to, and then choose the client's phone number. Then I'll scroll up and hit save. So the client will fill out this form and hit submit. I'll go into the project in Dubsado. Instead of having to reference that form every time I want to find out the client's first name or phone number, that information has been mapped over here. So every time I log into this project, I can quickly see the client's name, email address, phone number, company name, website name, etc. It's just a super handy feature.
If you're eager to get started with Dubsado now, I do have a free 5-day email course called Dubsado Workflow Secrets. I'll link to that down below so you can get started right away. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to this YouTube channel and click the bell icon for notifications. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up so I know you liked it. That's all for today. I'll see you next time. Bye.